Hi, I'm Jess Mayo. I'm a Senior Associate Test Engineer in the Data Management Division at SAS. And this is Bringing It All Together, using SAS data preparation to integrate all your data sources. When data is integrated in one space and combined together into one larger data set, we can answer questions that could never be answered by each data set individually. This provides a more holistic picture and allows you to gain more valuable insights into your data. But what if you have data stored in multiple different locations, multiple different servers, and multiple different file types? Accessing and standardizing that data can be incredibly challenging. No matter where your data is stored, you should be able to access it and easily integrate it into your analytics lifecycle. With access to over 60 different types of data and counting, SAS breaks down those data silos and facilitates easy data integration across all your data sources, from delimited files and spreadsheets, Hadoop, MySQL, images and social media, on-site or in the cloud. SAS Data Explorer and SAS Data Studio guide you through accessing the data and combining the data sets together without you ever having to move or store your data elsewhere. In this demo, I'll walk through a real-world example of how we can access data from different sources and combine the data sets together. We'll look at three different data sets to view data on customers from a specific bank. These are the bank's most loyal customers, ones that have a bank account, a checking or savings, a home equity loan, and a credit card. If we can learn more about these customers and their habits, we can advertise to people similar to them and gain more business. To learn more about these customers and their habits, I need to bring the data together. Let's start by taking a look inside Data Explorer. I can get here by selecting the application switcher on the left and choosing Manage Data. First, I need to import my first piece of data, which is a text file on my machine. I'll select the Import tab, Local File, and this opens up a Windows Explorer. I'll select bankcustomers.txt to add this to the import queue. From here, I can change the table name and target location if I want to, and select to replace the file. While it's importing, if I wanted to, I could have selected to save as an in-memory table only. Notice that the table successfully imported with the green message strip and is ready for use. From here, I'll choose Actions, Prepare Data, to open this up in SAS Data Studio. I can drag and drop a join transformation from the Transform panel on the left to the Plan Property panel on the right. This automatically opens up the join dialog. First, I'll start by selecting the pencil icon to select Table 2. This now opens up a Choose Data dialog, which looks exactly like SAS Data Explorer application that we were just in, because it is. This is SAS Data Explorer as a dialog. In here, I can import the next table, which contains home equity loan data. Back on the Import tab, I can select Folders. This dialog shows files stored in the file service. Inside my folder, HMEQ, I have home equity loans Excel file. Click OK, and this file gets added to the import queue. Again, I can choose to change the target table name and location if I want to, and replace the file if it already exists in that location. While it's importing, notice there's a couple features specific to Excel files, such as specifying a specific worksheet in a file if there are more than one, and limiting the range of imported rows and columns. Click OK once the table successfully imports. I want to take a moment to highlight some other features of the Join Tables dialog before we add our last table. Customer ID in Table 1 matched with Table 2 automatically. If I had other columns I wanted to join on, perhaps first name and last name, I can click the plus icon and add that join condition. I can also specify the type of join with this icon, whether I want a full, left, right, or inner join. I'm going to stick with inner join because I only want customers that exist in all datasets. Click the double table icon to add a third table to the join. Again, click the pencil icon to open the Choose Data dialog. From here, I want to go to the Data Sources tab. My last table contains information on customers with credit cards and is stored in Oracle, so I'll access it through an Oracle CAS library. To create a new connection to a database, click the connection icon and enter the connection information. Change the type from file system to database, and fill in the important information such as username, password, path, and schema. To finish creating this connection, click Save. I already have this set up, so I'm going to cancel out of this dialog and drill into the CAS Shared Default Server and find my Oracle library. Notice the connection information appears on the right when I drill into the Oracle library. Scroll down to find the credit card customers table, right-click and select Load to load this table into memory. This table is persisted in Oracle, but now I've loaded it into memory so that I can access it and use it in Viya. I didn't have to physically move this table anywhere. The credit card customers table is loaded into memory when the icon changes to include a lightning bolt. Click OK. Customer ID column in Table 1 matched to a similarly named column in Table 3, so our join conditions are set. By unchecking the Select All Columns checkbox, two more tabs in the Join Tables dialog become enabled. The first tab will allow me to select only the columns in the input tables that I want to show up in the output table. If you scroll down, any column from a subsequent table with the same name as the column in a previous table will have _1 appended, so we can easily filter out those columns that are duplicates. For now, I'll accept the default All Columns. The Rename Columns tab allows me to specify output column names, labels if I want them, and formats. I'll rename the Address column to Address but proper case, and Bank Account NO to Bank ACCT number. Now I'll click OK on the Join Tables dialog. Notice when I did that, a message strip appeared above the table indicating that the session table is not current to the plan. I need to run the join transformation so that the table gets updated with those join conditions that I specified. The join transformation has run and the session table is now updated with a bunch of new columns coming from the credit card and home equity table. This new table contains only the rows of customers of all three types of accounts. Let's see how we can start to use this data to gain more valuable insights. Click Save As to save the plan and output table. I'll save the plan in my folder and change the name to indicate that this is the Bank Customers All plan. I'll also change the target table name so that we know this is the All Customers output table. If I wanted to, I could change the physical file format stored on disk, but I'll stick with SAS/HDAT. And I'll click Save. Once the plan saves, I can reopen it in the future and make modifications. Once the table saves, I can seamlessly move to the next stage of the analytics lifecycle. I can simply select the overflow icon, Actions, Save Table, Explore and Visualize to bring up the Save Table in Visual Analytics. I can start to explore my data and see what insights I can gather from this much larger combined table. I'll drag and drop a bar chart onto the report canvas, change the direction to vertical, and start assigning some data roles. I'll analyze loyalty level, which comes from the credit card table, measure with household income coming from the banking table, requested loan amount and value of current property from the home equity table, and lattice by gender, again from the banking table. These three datasets combined together in one space let us explore way more patterns and relationships than we can ever explore from just one of these tables alone. And there we have it. In less than 10 minutes, we were able to access data from three different sources in SAS Data Explorer, integrate them together into one dataset using SAS Data Studio, and begin to explore and gather valuable insights into the data using SAS Visual Analytics. I hope this demo showed you how easy it is to use SAS data preparation to integrate all your data sources. Thank you for watching.